Hi folks,
and welcome to the 100th episode of Meaningful Money. Hello, did you like the new titles? I do, because I made them. Here we are back on Battery Rocks in Penzance, and this is where it all started. This is where I shot my first video here back last April 2010. I decided to set up this site after reading a book by a guy called Gary Vaynerchuk, who decided back in 2006 to use YouTube and the internet to teach the world about wine. I read his book and thought I could do that, but not about wine, but basic financial planning. Well, I bought a flip cam, came and shot the first one here, and shot another 20 videos before I told anybody what I was doing. Then I spoke to a couple of good friends, and a quick shout out here to Richard Allen and Ben Crockford, and also finally told my wife what I was doing. They all thought I might just be onto something. So I got a few more videos up and eventually went live on July 23rd, 2010. Well, look, this is episode 100, and it's been quite an 11 months really. In that time, I've won two awards for this site primarily. First one from IFA Life, thank you Phil Calvert and the team, for my use of social media, YouTube and all that, to spread the word about what I was doing. But definitely the year's been capped off for me by last month, February 2011, winning the Professional Advisor Award for Financial Education. Just delighted for this sort of humble website, one guy on a camera down in West Cornwall, great to be recognised by the industry. Here's the point at which I got given the award at the ceremony.
The winner of the Financial Education Award is Jackson Financial Services.
Come on!
One happy customer.
Yeah, that was a good night. fantastic evening celebrating national recognition, really. It was a big deal for me. Now, probably the best decision I made shooting these videos was shooting them outside, because it'd be even more boring if I was just sat behind my desk in a suit talking about this stuff. And fortunately, I live in a beautiful part of the world when there's always something good to a good place to set up the camera. But shooting outside has its perils as well. You know, I've been rained on, obviously. I've been pooed on by seagulls. I've had the camera blow over in the wind. But the clip I'm going to show you in a minute was where I nearly got run over by a tractor. Here it is.
Which are the alternative to these ones, defined benefits. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned and see you next time.
That was way back in episode 48, talking about final salary pensions, I think. But my favourite one, I think, remember the purpose of this is to explain financial stuff in easy language. My favourite episode, I think, ever is one where I shot up at the Merry Maidens, not far from where I live, talking about shares and specifically the concept of supply and demand, which is how shares are valued. And I did that using a stick. Yeah, I know, sounds bizarre, but here it is.
But what stocks and shares are all about, really, and what, to be honest, most investments are about, they're only worth what somebody is prepared to buy them for. So their valuation is entirely based on supply and demand. For instance, if I want to sell you this stick, it's a nice stick, but if I tell you it's worth £100, you, if you've got any sense, would, you know, laugh me out of town. You'd say, well, I'm not paying you £100 for a stick. And because I want to sell it, but you don't want to buy it, this stick is essentially worthless. But if you're a stick collector, you might think that this is the nicest stick you've ever seen and be prepared to pay me £100. So you've got the demand, and I am going to supply you with this lovely stick. And so the valuation of this stick is all about supply and demand. And it's the same with most investments, and it's certainly the same with shares. And that is why the stock market, the place where shares are bought and sold, goes up and down, and up and down, depending on sentiment.
Hopefully that got the point across. A little bit surreal. But I'm obviously having a blast doing these. I love doing them. It's a labour of love, really. But it's been nearly a year now, and I've got a couple of announcements to make. One major one, really. Since the Professional Advisor Awards, I've been looking for a company to partner with, somebody to sponsor this website, to help me make it bigger and better, to spread the word a bit more. Now, as you know, I'm a financial planner and director of Jackson's Financial Services in Penzance. And for 6 years, we've been working with a firm of investment managers in London called Seven Investment Management. You've already met their marketing director, Justin Urquhart Stewart, because he's been kind enough to join me on these videos a couple of times in the recent past. He's the guy with the red braces, and he's a markets genius and is often on the TV and the radio. But he's just one of a fantastic team of 7IM. As I say, we've been working with them for years at Jackson's, but I'm delighted to announce that they have now agreed to become lead sponsor of Meaningful Money. So, to just explain why they're doing that, and through the miracles of the internet and some judicious editing, Justin Urquhart Stewart now joins me, not quite live, from London. Hi, Justin. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Hello, Pete. Yes, I may not be live, but I'm certainly alive anyway.
Welcome to Meaningful Money.
My pleasure. Good to be here.
Justin, appreciate you joining me. I wonder if you can just very quickly say why you decided, you and all the team at 7IM, decided to sponsor Meaningful Money. And obviously I'm looking for an answer other than because I asked you to.
Oh, surely I can give that answer. No, of course the truth really is actually all to do with proper education to make sure that people have a better way of finding out really first-rate opinions, view, and data as to what's going on in financial services. And I have to say, the innovation that you brought through here really has been fantastic, and as you well know, has already been award-winning. Congratulations.
Fantastic. Justin, I wonder, part of the reason that I set up this site is because I believe that due to legislation changes next year, access to good advice will become more difficult for ordinary people. The wealthy will always be able to pay for good advice, but for ordinary people, that's going to become more difficult, I think. Can you say how important do you think good financial education is going to be going forward?
You only have to look at what's happening around us all in society at the moment. People are frightened, they're confused, they don't know what's going on. The good news, we're all going to be living longer. The bad news is most of us aren't financially fit to be able to actually fulfill the life course. So we need to find and learn more. And it's vital that we start this right from school, right the way through. Not how to write out a cheque or run a credit card, but to understand what where your money's going, what returns you need. And after all, for many people, we're probably going to be retired for longer than we were working. So we need to fund that, and we need to understand that, and therefore we need education, and that's why we need Meaningful Money.
Thank you, Justin. Obviously, I agree. That's why I set up this site in the first place. Thanks for joining me. I look forward to working with you over the coming months.
Look forward to it, Pete. Thanks a lot.
So it's great that I've got a sponsor to help me. I'm delighted it's 7IM. They've become good friends of ours at Jackson's. And from now on in the videos, you'll see their logo down in the bottom right here. So I need your help now. I need you to help me spread the word about Meaningful Money. And to do that, I've put a tweet, or it could be a Facebook status as well, underneath the post here on the website, on the YouTube channel, and also on the Facebook page. And the idea is that I want you to put that in your Facebook status, or tweet it out, or in your LinkedIn status, wherever really. And that has a hashtag in it so that I can track everybody that does that, and make a list. Then I'll use a random number generator to pick out somebody to win 50 quid on iTunes. It's not much, but it's a thank you for helping me spread the word. So it's Friday the 18th now, 2 days earlier when I'm filming, but it's Friday the 18th that this video goes live. The competition will run till Friday the 25th, and I'll pick and announce the winner then. So thank you in advance for helping me spread the word about this website. So it just remains for me to say thank you to you again. 100 episodes and people are still watching. I'm now getting 50 views a day easily, and that's extremely humbling to me. So I'd love for it to be 100, 150 a day, because then I know that people are benefiting, not just from watching me prat around here in West Cornwall, but hopefully benefiting from useful financial information as well. So thank you to you. And it's a celebration. So if you bear with me 1 second. I thought it was worth popping a cork, given that it's a big birthday. So cheers to you. Here we go. Whoa, yes. Try not to get any on the camera. Hope I haven't. But thank you very much and cheers. See you next time.